fact, coming after IIT Roorkee, I must say that compared to traditional Roorkee, I said that I'm very new. So I think there are a mix of institutes. IIT Delhi is coming up. And again, I said Banapur, which is the newest actually. So we'll start my presentation about ICER Kolkata. But before that, I just wanted to tell about the ICER system because this is the first presentation of the ICER. Of course, Banapur director is going to come in this session. And Shashi Dhara is going to also present the ICER Pune, though I curiously found ICER Pune to be the least of the private institutions in the presentation. But I must mention that ICER Pune is not a private institution. It's a part of the ICER family. Have you seen that? Yeah, you see that session. You are the private institution.
He was listed for Ashoka. He was listed for Ashoka University.
Yeah. No, he's talking about ICER. So I just thought I'll correct the young people. But ICER Pune is also part of the ICERs, among the government institution. In fact, ICER Pune and Kolkata started only 2006. In fact, if I go back and say that which was the earliest, it's very difficult to say actually, because both of them came around the same time. I will only say that ICER Kolkata teaching started one day before ICER. So this I came to know recently, just one day before, and I know who was the first teacher, Professor Ananda Mohan Das Gupta in physics. He was the first teacher in the entire ICER system. He took the morning class in ICER Kolkata on that day. That's just for history. 2006, both of them came up. 2007, Mohali came. 2008, Bhopal and Thiruvananthapuram came, and then Tirupati came in 2015. There's a long gap. And very recently, in 2016, the youngest ICER, Banapur, has come. This is a snapshot. Again, this kind of data is very dangerous to present. Because first of all, I'm not sure how updated the data is. Of course, it is not updated, but I have tried to get up to August 2018. And you can see the different number of students. Pune, Kolkata, Mahali, the ratio of females, the number of PhD students, faculty strength, and so on. What is important is to note the NIRF ranking. We are now the number one among the ICERs at 55, and ICER Pune is 32, then 55, 56, 58. These are the five ICERs which have been recently ranked because Tirupati and Dharampur are yet to come into the NIRF list. What is good to see that all the five ICERs are among the top 60. This is very good because they are all within 10, 12 years. And if I look back at IITs, it is very hard to compare. But I would say that among all the institutions which came at the time of 2006, if I am right, then ICER Kolkata is only beaten by IIT Hyderabad. They are number 22. Otherwise, all the other institutions are much older than us. Universities are older. So in that sense, I can proudly say that we have done well. And I hope we continue to do well. Again, these are data that I am not very sure, but one thing that is sure is that our research publications are very high. ICER Pune has external projects, which is the highest, and then the rest of the data is not here. You know, for those who are interested, I can share. But this is just to give you a presentation of all the ICER. Our publication record has always been good in Kolkata. I must say that, and I hope the external projects will also improve. So this is our campus. I come now to ICER Kolkata. This is our campus of 201 acres. And as I said, our NIRF ranking, unfortunately, NIRF does not rank in the category of science. Unlike engineering, which I have not understood why they have written actually to the minister, that there should be a separate category of science. So we can only compete in the overall ranking. And we are there 25, as you can see, as I told you. And except IIT Hyderabad, were better than most of the institutions which came out. So very quickly, I will say that we have 104 faculty at the present moment. Offer has been given to another 8 who are all likely to join in the next 3 months. So we have practically 112 with 1,456 students on record, 94 non-teaching staff and so on. Importantly, 5 departments, I'll give the names in the department, who actually give degrees. And there are 4 interdisciplinary centers of research. And 2 more new departments we have just added, humanities and computer science. We are not giving degree, but they are mainly for interdisciplinary research. And we have a vision that we want to become an institute of excellence in science. And very importantly, all ICERs have this vision that teaching and undergraduate education are integrated in the state-of-the-art interdisciplinary research. So this is the motto of all the ICERs, and I'm pretty sure that they will all do well in years to come. We are very highly qualified faculty, even though we are young, and many of our faculties are recognized by several awards and honors. And as I said, we are publishing in very good journals in Nature, Nature Chemistry, Nature Photonics, Proceedings of National Academy of Science, TRL, JAX. So many of our faculties have been already doing quite well. We have already some patents also filed, product development. So we are also looking at translation of science, not just doing basic science. Currently, we have 5 departments. So I want to again repeat this, which offer BSMS course. So many people who do not know, this is an integrated 5-year course after class 12. So we have 3 channels of admission, KPPY, State Board Exam, and JEE Advanced. So this is how we take the BSMS students. We have integrated PhD, which starts after PhD, after BSc, and of course the standard PhD program, which starts after Master. So these are 3 major programs. But we also give MS by research in certain interdisciplinary areas. Again, it is not so highlighted. Material science, nonlinear phenomena, optics, nanosystems, astrophysics, and space sciences, some of the interdisciplinary research. And this is basically meant for engineering students, BTEC, who want to pursue their career in specific areas of physical science. It is called MS by research. So again, very less number of people have got it, but this program actually exists. 2 new departments we have started just recently, computer science and humanities. Obviously, they will not offer the undergraduate degrees, they have decided to do it consciously, but they will provide input to the BSMS programs and will also conduct PhD programs if possible. We have 4 interdisciplinary centers, Center of Excellence in Space Sciences, Center for Advanced Functional Materials, National Center for High Pressure, and Center for Climate and Environmental Studies. These are mainly among this department, the faculties have started these centers. These are broad research areas in each of the departments. Again, these of course keep changing, but this is as of today, the Department of Biological Sciences, Department of Chemical Sciences, I will not read them, but you can see Department of Earth Sciences, Mathematics and Statistics, and Department of Physical Sciences. So these are the 5 departments which actually exist, who give the BSMS degree, as well as IPhD, integrated PhD, and normal PhD. So I just want to now tell one of the opportunities for faculty, recruitment particularly. So we have immediate vacancies for about 20 to 25 faculty. And this will keep growing as you have more students. So we are building hostels, so more students, and 10:1 ratio faculty will also grow. But we have immediate vacancies, which we want to fill within 1 year. We are recruiting at all levels, not just an assistant professor, but also mid-career recruitment like associate professor and even some senior professors. So they are obviously based on outstanding CV, performance, and all the MHRD guidelines, which are actually there in the website, so I don't have to tell. But just to tell for all assistant professors, which many of you may be interested, we require PhD plus 3 years of postdoc experience. As per MHRD guidelines, with that we cannot relax. And of course, our teaching experience will always help. So basically we are recruiting in all these areas. So we try to give good facilities for research, but also we are setting up incubation and innovation centers for those who are interested in our campus, so that our research can be translated into devices and products and for the benefit of the society. Of course, academic entrepreneurship is not very easy, and I think Dr. Sivarao, who is also our honorary professor, will be speaking tomorrow. I saw that about the challenges of entrepreneurship in academic environment. We give startup grant, not necessarily very liberal. The amount varies from case to case, so I don't want to tell a particular amount. But it is not bad, I can tell you. So all joining faculties we give, all. So you don't have to actually ask for it. You just have to give a proposal as you join and you give a startup grant. There is a minimum startup grant that I can announce, the 20 lakhs you give. So minimum 20 lakhs you give, including recurring and non-recurring. However, all faculties are encouraged to apply for external grants, which are administered by SERG, DST, DBT, etc., on science. And there have been already discussion on that. And also look for funding from industry sources. In fact, there are a lot of nice success stories that our faculties have done already. So there are also upgradations to take place to normal recruitment process. We also provide in-campus housing and several other amenities which exist in and around the campus. So, yeah, I just want to tell that our students are also very well placed in terms of awards and fellowship. Many of them are already been placed in institutions like MIT, Harvard, Oxford, Cambridge, and so on. They have been also selected as faculty in IIT Gandhinagar, DRA, IIT Chennai, which is not bad for a 10-year, 12-year institution. Because you see, the first 5 years is BSMS, then PhD. So they are just about coming out after 2 or 3 years of postdoc. So I think we are able to make a mark in terms of good students. Just to tell you that in terms of national importance, we have some big projects of LIGO, India, Aditya L1, Space Mission. We have research of societal relevance, particularly projects of arsenic contamination, epidemic disease, drug delivery, cancer, biodiversity, urban ecology. And very importantly, we already have some startups, we have faculties. In fact, I want to tell that, and some product development which is going on with, again, the chemistry department to add additives and keep the industry Chennai. So we are also encouraging a lot of industry, industrial R&D. So we have also funding from TCG Life Sciences, we are actually leading corporate social responsibility contribution, Invictus Ontology, and so on. So I think it's very nice that although we are set out to do basic science, we have been able to make a mark in terms of industrial research. So I will not talk much about this. We have a lot of outreach activities. In fact, our students are extremely active in several activities in the Northeast, Ekpahal, Ishan Vikas Program, and various other activities. So as I told you, in terms of looking at international students, we have also registered as a partner institution in Study in India program. So we hope to get international students. We have, for translation, we have set up incubation center, which is now we call RISE Foundation, ISER. It's a Section 8 company, and DST Nidhi scheme has actually funded us. So this center, we hope we'll be able to connect from lab to the market several examples. All right, so I think this is the, I just end with the vision plan. That essentially we want to establish the global brand to cutting-edge education and research in basic and translational research in the national priorities. And we want to be among the top 100 institutions in the world ranking, at least in 15 or 20 years. I think this is something that we have been telling, that the world ranking, you know, we must be able to come within the 5. We are now, actually this year we have